This is the Gaumont British News, presenting the world to the world.
The war has flared up again in East Africa, and the Rome radio is once more preparing the Italian people for bad news, following Bardia, Soloum, and Tobruk. Over 1,000 miles from Bardia, British forces have already retaken the important strategical station of Cassala. The ever-increasing aggressive raids by our patrols have compelled the enemy to flee almost without a struggle, in spite of their superiority in numbers. The frontier from the Sudan to Abyssinia is marked by barbed wire entanglements, but these are pierced by our patrols like matchwood in their onward thrust to gain new territory. The presence of British military experts in the heart of Abyssinia, advising patriot leaders in their rising against the Italians, lends special significance to the flaring up of British activity on this front. The deep mountain gorges have given excellent daily cover for our advancing troops. They have inflicted severe casualties on the enemy at incredibly low cost to us. Loyal war drums have sounded along the frontier and from the hilltops of Abyssinia. The Emperor Haile Selassie is once more on the soil of his beloved land. The warrior chieftains of these wild and desolate passes are mad with excitement and are rallying round their emperor in their thousands. Owing to the density of the forests in these intractable parts, it is extremely difficult for these British Sudanese troops to clear the ground for landing fields. The many rivers offer no small obstacle to our advance. Yet advance we have, and shall continue to do so until victory has been won. Our secret patrols have done magnificent work all along the line. It is clear that the taking of Cassala has removed the threat to the Sudan once and for all, and replaced it by a very formidable one to Abyssinia.